Hi, I'm an RAF test pilot assigned to XLI Test and Evaluation Squadron, and I'm flying the RAF's very latest combat aircraft, Tempest, a sixth generation jet fighter.
It's a culmination of years of work. The very latest combat aircraft for the Royal Air Force. She's not just a jet, she's a leap forward in technology, a true sixth generation fighter. Although most things about Tempest are classified, I can reveal to you that I can interact with a virtual cockpit displayed on my helmet-mounted system, supported by augmented and virtual reality to reduce cockpit hardware. The aircraft's radar gives me 10,000 times more data than current systems.
The aircraft uses intelligent weapon systems using artificial intelligence and machine learning, and the system exploits information from the aircraft
to maximize the effect that weapons can deliver. All weapons are stored in a bomb bay to reduce the aircraft profile to enemy radar systems. All right, as we engage deep learning AI for unmanned flight, our wingmen, the swarming drones, activate. Direct energy weapons are online.
One of the main weapons this aircraft will carry are ultra-long-range, over-horizon air-to-air missiles, incorporating the very latest AI technology.
There are reports circulating on the internet that the Tempest has an operational range of 2,415 kilometers, allowing
the Tempest to cross the Atlantic Ocean and reach the United States without having to refuel. This, of course, would be an amazing achievement and one I could not possibly confirm. The aircraft's speed, well, let me just say, is a theoretical estimate, as yet untested. Claims the aircraft at high altitude can reach a top speed of 2,300 miles per hour may or may not be correct. After all, 2,300 miles per hour, or 3,700 kilometers an hour, is awfully fast. In the near future, Tempest will be escorted with extended mission wingmen drones. Matching Tempest's speed and agility, they will reduce pilot information overload by operating autonomously, constantly gathering information from an integrated network of satellites, on ground monitoring stations, naval assets,
and a range of reconnaissance systems, such as AWACS. These wingman drones will be armed with air-to-air missiles
and have the ability to strike ground targets. The wingman drones will also incorporate a 300 kilogram warhead.
And if required, can transform itself to a hypersonic missile system to neutralize large targets.
Tempest itself can carry an internal payload of 10,000 pounds, or just over 4,500 kilograms, within two weapon bays, doubling the capacity of a Lockheed F-35A internal weapons load. Air forces are sacrificing or reducing the F-35 stealth capability by adding external hardpoints for more weapon systems. Tempest, though, will use mission-specific payload configurations, often incorporating autonomous short to medium range, one-mission swarm drones. These will carry varying size of warhead explosives. Tempest will significantly increase its payload capability externally, not by carrying the weapons itself, but by using deployed wingmen drones armed with a range of missiles, with each incorporating 200 to 300 kilogram warheads. The wingman can also carry racks of seek and destroy swarm drones in its internal weapons bay. These will be released over the conflict zone to neutralize enemy radar, troops, and military hardware. And the most amazing thing, well, I'm actually flying the aircraft thousands of miles away.
Sat in the world's most advanced remote cockpit, on the ground, from an undisclosed location, somewhere in the UK.
The Tempest is currently the most technically advanced jet fighter ever created, and it can either be manned or, like now, remotely operated.
The actual Tempest Future Combat Air Systems flying demonstrator is expected to make its first flight by December 2027.
It will be attended by senior Air Force and government officials from United Kingdom, Italy, and Japan, who have committed to purchasing Tempest fighter jets.
That first flight will be at BAE Systems in Wharton, England.
Thank you.